Okay.
Janvinus next to me.
Listen carefully. Today, by today and tomorrow, I will finish the lesson. I will explain everything will finish tomorrow, by today and tomorrow. Okay. From Sunday onwards, we will solve the questions from the reader as well as worksheet. So be ready with worksheet and notebook reader Sunday. Be ready with your worksheet and the reader by Sunday. I hope all of you got your reader. Yes, children?
Yes.
Yes, okay. Yes, teacher.
Okay, those who didn't download worksheet. Not today, Sunday. Children, listen. Those who didn't download your worksheet, you are getting time. See, children, tomorrow, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. 3 days you are getting. You can download from the school website or school app. I think mobile app, yes. From there you can download and be ready, okay. Then by the time you just read your lesson thoroughly, I will ask any question from the reader. Okay. And listen carefully. While I am teaching, I used to say many things. Not only the reader. I am giving you more information. Isn't it?
Yeah,
I'm not following only the reader, I'm following reader. Not only the reader, I'm giving you more informations about the topics, what we are discussing now. So I will ask every question what I have taught in the class. Okay? So be very careful.
Okay.
Listen again very carefully. I have told you, I will not only follow the reader, I will give you some extra information. So listen. So, let me share my screen. Today's class we will start. Okay? So, be careful. In between, I will ask anyone to read. So, be very careful. Yes, children. Is it visible? Screen is visible, children?
Yes, teacher.
Yeah. Listen carefully. Now, we have finished last period, last class about flowers, parts of a flower and functions of a flower. Isn't it, Silen?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes,
what are the different parts of a flower?
Flower, buds, leaves, stem.
No. What are the different parts of a flower? I have asked you. Okay, tell. No problem. Tell me. Who knows the answer? Tell me.
I.
Okay, tell. What's your name?
Sunflower. Sunflower.
Stings, stamens, pits,
yes.
Petals.
Yes.
The start.
Children, I have. Okay, I have taught you in an order. I have followed order. See, I have told you, you start from stalk, sepal, petal, stem, pistil. So you will not make a mistake. If you will learn the order, you will not find a mistake. You will not make any mistake in between. No need you will think again what in between, what is this. Learn by order, okay? Stalk, sepal, petal, sepal, petal, stamen and pistil. Okay, and each part and functions of each part, you know it. Yes, children. About petals, you know. Sepals, you know. Stalk means what you know. Stamens means you know. And pistil means you know. Okay. See here, parts of a flower is shown. One more time. You can see here each part. Okay. Stalk. S-T-A-L-K. Stalk. L is silent. Don't read stalk. It's wrong. Okay, stalk. Stalk is the part where the flower is attached to the stem. So we can say stalk is like stem. The part of the plant, stalk is the part that helps the plant to attach with the stem. I hope it's clear to you. Next, learn sepals. Sepals are the green leaf-like structure. And the function of sepal is protect the flower bud. Protect the flower bud. Next, petals. Petals are the most colorful part of a plant and so it attracts insects. And most of the flowers petals have very pleasant smell. So bees or butterflies, or we can say insects, are attracted by the petals. Here you can see stamens. Stamens consist of pollen grains. Stamens consist of pollen grains. Here you can see pistils. Pistil is the female reproductive organ, and it has more different parts that you will learn in class 5. Here in class grade 4 you have to know pistil is the female reproductive organ. After that we have learned functions of flowers. Flowers help in reproduction. And I have told you, I have taught you, in reproduction two processes are involved: pollination and fertilization. Pollination is the process by which pollination is the process of transfer of pollen grains from stamen to the pistil. I have told you the tip of the pistil. The tip of the pistil is called stigma. S-T-I-G-M-A. Stigma. Okay, children. So, pollination is the process. The process of pollination is a process. So, we have to know how to define that process. The process of transfer of pollen grains from one flower to another is called pollination. So I am repeating, children, the process of transfer of pollen grains from one flower to another is called pollination. Or you can say, you can define pollination, the process of transfer of pollen grains from stamen. We know pollen grains are present in stamen or on stamen. So, from the stamen, it reaches to the stigma of the flower. Stigma means pistil. The tip of the pistil is called the stigma. Stigma is the female reproductive organ part. The part of the female reproductive organ. So, stamen is the pollen grain. Pollen grains are the male reproductive part of the male reproductive organ. From the male, it reaches to the female organ. That is called pollination. I hope you got it, children. Tell me yes or no. Did you understand?
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Okay. Yes. So, yes.
Okay. Suppose the question comes like, define pollination. Are you able to answer? Define the process pollination. Are you able to answer, children?
Yes.
Okay, then answer now. Tell me what. Tell me answer now. What is pollination? Answer me now, children. Come on.
The process of
transfer one flower to another is called pollination.
Pollination.
Okay, you didn't tell transfer of what? What is transferring? Pollen grains.
Of pollen grains.
Pollen grains. Okay, the process of transfer of pollen grains from one flower to another, or pollen grains from stamen to the stigma. It will be more clear. Stamen to the stigma. Stigma means, you know. Yes, children? The tip of the pistil is stigma. So, pollen grains transfer from stamen to the stigma is called pollination. After pollination, fertilization can happen. That fertilization, what is mean fertilization, and what are the remaining process, you will learn in grade 5. Here you have to know, flowers help in reproduction. Flowers help in reproduction. So we know that pollination is the part of reproduction, and bees and butterflies are the insects that help in the process of pollination. Okay, children. And one or two other ways are there: pollination by wind, pollination by animals, pollination by insects, like that, two, three more ways are there that you will learn in grade 5. Okay, here you have to know when the butterflies or bees will sit on the flower to suck nectar or be attracted by the colors. So the stamens or pollen grains will stick on the leg part or mouth part of the same bee or butterfly, and after it will go to another flower that is transferred to another flower, that is pollination. Okay, you have seen that picture last class. Do you remember one bee was sitting on one flower and it is going to another flower? That is pollination. Okay, children. And flower has one more function. Some plants store excess food in their flowers. Some plants store excess food. We can see here two examples. Read, children. What are the two examples you can see?
Cauliflower and broccoli.
Yeah, these are the two flowers. They store excess food made by the leaf. They store in their flowers. Okay, cauliflower and broccoli, both are flowers we can use as our food because the extra food made by the leaf is stored in it. Yes, children. Now, we have to know the next part. Some flowers change into fruits. You know it, yes? Some flowers change into fruits. Yeah. Some flowers change into fruit. Here you can see some of the pictures of some of the fruits. And inside the fruit, there is seed or there are seeds. Here you can see some of the examples. Children, fruits we can classify into two types. One is edible fruit and another one non-edible fruit. Listen to me. Edible means to be eaten. Edible means?
To be eaten means what? We can use
as our food. See, children, yes. Two examples are given, mango and apple. I have put only two examples. You know many fruits are edible. Yes, children?
Yes, teacher.
So the question can be asked like that. Write two examples of edible fruits. You can write example mango, apple, grapes, pomegranate, strawberries, or what are the examples you know you can write. Yeah. But
bananas.
Listen to me. Come on. But some fruits are non-edible. What is meant by non-edible?
Not eaten.
We should not eat it. Okay. So two examples are given for non-edible fruits. Datura and foxglove. Children, see the spelling. Datura. See? D-A-T-U-R-A. Datura and foxglove. Okay, children? Datura and foxglove. These are the two examples of non-edible fruits. Okay. Fruits can be divided into two categories. Two types. Categories means types. Okay? Listen to me. Edible fruits and non-edible fruits. Here you can see two examples for both. Okay? Edible fruits are given and non-edible fruits are given. Mango and apple spellings are given. You learn that the Datura spelling. D-A-T-U-R-A. Datura and foxglove. F-O-X-G-L-O-V-E. Okay? These are the two examples for non-edible fruits. Children, next, we are going to learn functions of fruits. It's very easy. Fruits protect the seeds. We know, children, inside the fruits, seeds are present. So, seeds are protected by the fruit. Did you understand, Silen?
Yes.
Understand.
Okay. So what is the?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Very good, Silen. Tell me, what is the function of a fruit?
Protect
the seeds.
Protect
the seeds. You can see on the screen, yeah?
Yes.
Functions of fruit. Fruits protect the seeds. Okay. I am repeating, children. Fruits protect the seeds. See, here you can see fruits and the seeds are inside. Here you can see, here this fruit, when we open this fruit, you can see the seeds inside, okay? Listen. Okay, mute your microphone, children. Now we are going to learn about how many seeds present. Some fruits have only one seed. Here you can see two examples. Peach and mango. And almonds. Almonds also have only one seed. Peach, mango, avocado, all these are examples for one seeded fruit. They have only one seed. Next we can see some fruits have few seeds. Example, apple, orange. You can write more examples. Grapes. See here, some fruits have few seeds. Example, apple, orange. Here, some fruits have many seeds. Example, you can write kiwi, papaya, watermelon. Children, now today we are learning about what are the functions of fruit. Fruits protect the seeds. And after that we are learning, maybe some fruits have one seed, some of them have few seeds, some of them have few seeds, and some of them have many seeds. You can see examples for each. Fruits have one seed. Example, peach, mango. Peach, mango. Children, can you repeat after me? Peach, mango. Peach.
Peach, mango.
Example for what? Example for what?
One seed.
These are the two examples of fruits with one seed.
Peach,
mango. Learn it, yes?
Yes.
Everyone know the answer now, yes?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Good children. Very good children. I'm repeating, but okay, some fruits have one seed. Example, peach, mango.
Some fruits have
few seeds. Example, apple, orange. Two examples for each. Okay, yes. Before this speech, I have taught you, fruits can be classified into two. Edible fruit, non-edible fruit. Edible fruit means fruits that are eatable. And non-edible fruits means that we cannot eat. Fruits that are unable to eat. Edible means to be eaten. Non-edible means not to eat. Okay, then after we are learning, fruits protect the seeds. That means we know seeds are present inside the fruits. And some fruits have one seed. Example, peach, mango. Some fruits have few seeds. Example, apple, orange.
Apple and orange.
Yeah. And next, some fruits have many seeds. Example,
kiwi and papaya.
Kiwi and papaya.
Yeah. We are going to learn functions of seed. Here you can see a new plant grows from seed. So we can say seeds help the plant to new plant. And second function, seeds also store excess food prepared by the plants. Here you can see many examples. Yes, children? Yes, my dear?
My mother is printing.
Printing? What?
Land. My mother drink a bucket of water with some tissue and put some seeds to grow a new plant.
Yeah, you can do it. It's an activity, okay? I will tell you that how to do it, okay? You can do it. It's like an activity. So you can see that how the seed will grow into a new plant. That you will learn that word is germination. How the seed will germinate and what are the steps of germination that you can watch. That is there for grade 5. Okay, children? Okay, my dear, that you will learn in grade 5. That process is called germination and many steps are there for germination that you will learn in grade 5. See here, you have to know functions of seed. We can say a new baby plant or new plant grows from seed. So we can say seeds help in reproduction. And in some seeds, store excess food prepared by the plant. Here you can see chickpeas and beans. We are using as our food because that excess food made by the plant is stored in the seed, even in the seed. So we have learned that each part of the plant can store excess food. We have learned the first class, roots store excess food. I will tell two examples, carrot and radish. And after that next period, we have learned stems store excess food. Underground stems store excess food. We call them tubers. And two examples we learned. Turmeric, you remember that two examples of underground stem?
Turmeric and potato.
Turmeric and potato. Very good. Okay, very good, children. After that, we have learned leaves. Ginger. Yes, very good. Okay, and ginger. And after that, we have learned leaves can store excess food. Example? Do you remember?
Cabbage and meat.
Very good. Cabbage and meat. Yes. Okay. After that, we have learned about flowers. Even flowers can store excess food. What are the two examples?
Broccoli and
cauliflower.
Very good. Okay. After that, we have learned about the fruits. Even fruits can store excess food. What are the two examples of edible fruits?
Apple,
orange, mango, many examples. And after that, we have learned seeds are also edible. Means even seeds can store excess food made by the leaves. So which are the examples? We can tell chickpeas, beans, all these are the seeds. Not only this, many seeds, we have the examples. Yes, children? You understood it, yes? Now, we will see the review question. Okay, question 1. Where are seeds present?
Inside the fruits.
In the fruits. Seeds are present in the fruits. Don't write. Don't do anything. You will just tell me the answer. That's all. Okay? Yes, children. See, children, question number 1, I asked, where are the seeds present? We can say the answer. Seeds are present inside the fruits. And so we can tell fruits protect the seeds. Seeds are present in the fruits. The function of the fruit is protect the seed. Function of fruit is protect the seed. Here, question 2. You can see, children, many examples. See, give any two examples of fruits with one seed. Here you can see two examples, yeah? Two, three examples, yes. You can see. You can name it, okay? Name that fruit. So many examples you can see. Here, fruits with many seeds. You can see many seeds. Few seeds you can see. Many seeds you can see. Okay, children?
Okay.
Very easy question. Now, we will learn, we will go through summary. What are the things we learn in this lesson? See, we have learned two main parts of a plant. Two main parts of plants. Okay, you answer me. What are the two main parts of plants? Two systems.
Two systems and root system.
We have learned
root system and shoot system.
Yes, two systems. Shoot system and shoot system. After that we have learned parts of shoot system and root system. And root system consists of only roots. Okay, but shoot system consists of different parts.
Stem, leaf,
flower, and seed. Okay, repeat, children.
Stem, leaf, flower, fruit, seed.
Okay, function. Then afterwards we have learned functions of each part. Okay, functions of root. Functions of stem, functions of leaf, functions of flower, functions of fruit, functions of seed. And see, children, very easily I will tell you, each part you can function, one function is same. Store excess food. Is it clear?
Clear.
Each part, any part of the flower, the question... Okay, listen, let me talk, please. If the question comes... Write function of any part. You can write the common function. Store food. It is a common for every part. Each part. Yes, children? Isn't it?
Yes.
It is clear. Yes. Okay. You don't need to learn anything. You can write one function. Same for every part. Each part. Stores excess food. And examples are different. Okay. But examples are different. Two examples you know. Okay, two roots store, name of the two plants that store excess food in their root, excess food in their stem, excess food in their leaves, excess food in their flowers, excess food in their fruits and seeds. All that, two examples you should learn. Okay, it's very easy. Yes? After that, see, parts of the plant is shown, leaf, fruit, stem, root. See, root system and root system. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah, very good, children. Now, one more time, you can see functions of seed. A new plant grows from seed and seeds also store excess food prepared by plants. You can see two functions. Seeds help in reproduction. A new plant grows from seed and seeds also store excess food prepared by plants. See, children, then one of your friend, he told me he is doing that activity to see the germination of the seed. You can take one seed, one or two seeds, put one Kleenex, pour little bit water on it, make the Kleenex wet, tissue wet, okay? The paper should be wet. Or you can... Yes, you did it? Very good.
Teacher.
Yes?
But wouldn't it become if we plant it?
Sorry?
Wouldn't it become when we do that?
No, you can do it. Repeat one more time. Okay, take one small piece, any type of seed. Okay, piece. This here is shown different types of beans. Yeah, you can see here. See? Chickpeas and like chickpeas here,
sure.
And the red bean. Yes.
I would love to plant avocados because I love them.
Avocado maybe will take time because the seed is, It will for to germination of avocado seed, it will take more days.
Teacher.
If you use this small seeds, it will germinate very fast.
Teacher.
Okay? Yes, my dear.
How to plant something?
How to plant something means what? Take a plant and plant it. Take one pot and plant if you have a plant. Okay?
It's like a sand. Bye, teacher.
Okay, bell rang, children.
Bye, teacher.
Okay, children. Very good, children. Okay.
Bye, teachers.
Bye, teacher. Thank you.
Until tomorrow. Bye. Have a nice day.
Bye.
Have a nice day. Okay.
Bye.
Okay.
Teacher, I love you so much.
Thank you. I too love you.
Teacher, thank you for making us educated.
Thank you, my dear. Thank you